My name is Patrick Shafto, and this is My Path to Math. My area of research is at the intersection of human and machine learning. One of the things that I'm interested in is providing mathematical foundations for humans and machines individually and working together. And so you might wonder, why would we want math for this? And there's a very practical answer, which is that, you know, if we're going to have these machines functioning in society, we want to be able to have some kinds of understanding of what the long-run consequences might be. And without a strong mathematical foundation, you really can't do that very easily. Growing up, I always enjoyed math a lot. But at some point, right around the time I was about to go to college, I was wondering sort of what I would do at the end of the day with, you know, my education. Marshfield is a small town, traditionally was a fishing village. And so it was sort of very much at the time anyway, very hands-on kind of community where people did labor type work or fishing or things like this. I didn't know, as far as I know, anyone who had a PhD. And so the whole idea of doing math for a living was not something that I could wrap my head around. And so I sort of drifted away from math because I couldn't find people who could tell me what it was good for. So I did an undergraduate degree in physical therapy, of all things, which is very practical, but not very mathematical. When I graduated from Northeastern, undergraduate, I stayed on for a year to do a master's degree and sort out what I was going to do in the longer term. And I learned about cognitive science. And so I went and talked to one of the faculty members about studying learning and managed to talk my way into a PhD program the next year in cognitive science. You know, I had a friend who had moved on to MIT. To do her PhD. She was a few years behind me. What was happening there at the time, this was sort of around 2004, was a really exciting time where machine learning and cognitive science were blending in an interesting way. And so that seemed clearly like the right place to go because, you know, you could combine the sort of rigor and applicability of machine learning to the study of cognitive science and learning more generally. But once I started getting into that, it became clear that it was necessary to have math to be precise about what you're claiming about how learning works. And so that was sort of the aha moment that was like, well, I really do need to pursue this a lot more vigorously than I have. And so that began the long path to math. My advice for people who are starting out in math is to find ways to use it, to understand what it's good for, because, you know, there are really an incredible number of questions for which math could be applicable, but isn't yet.